Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, The Physio Guide. I am Dr. Shaheen Khanum and today I am going to teach you about arthrogryposis. It's also called amyloplasia or arthrogryposis multiplex congenita. I am sure you would have heard of this term before and always skipped it because it feels like a tongue twister. Even this term is there in my own video of CTEV. So, and also think that this is a very difficult disease, but let me tell you, by the end of this video, you will not just be able to speak this term fluently, but also learn about it, that what it is exactly. And whenever you get a chance to see a patient, you will be able to examine and diagnose by your observation. But before that, I would like to say that if you like what I'm saying, then consider subscribing because that will motivate me to make more of such videos. So let's begin. Arthrogryposis multiplex congenita refers to the development of multiple joint contractures affecting two or more areas of the body prior to birth. It means that in this term, the first term is arthrogryposis, it means it is relating to joint arthro, and multiplex is more than two. Multiplex and a congenita, this is a congenital, so it is there before birth. So there is a stiffening around two or more joints before birth. That's it. Stiffening of two or more joints before birth. A child is born like that. The contracture can be in a flex position or an extended position, and it affects arms, legs, hands and feet. And this is a rare medical condition and occurs only in about 1 to 10,000 live births. There is no racial connection to it. Arthrogryposis is detected before birth by ultrasound. The majority of individuals with this condition are very bright or at least normal and average. And the lifespan depends upon the amount of severity and is often normal. The clinical presentation is such that the brain is completely normal and there is contracture with webbing of the skin behind the joints of knee, hip, elbow or shoulder. As you can see in this picture, the hand and fingers, they are flexed and outside, and then one side knee is extended, the other side there is a fixed flexion deformity, and the foot is like a club foot, like that's why I had discussed this condition in CTEV. And the other hand, you can see there is weakness. There is no specific reason for arthrogryposis, but the most common are intrauterine or genetic. Intrauterine means within the uterus, when the fetus were there, something wrong happened, or it's wrong from the genetics itself. So the presentation of genetic is that only the hand and the feet are affected. It means the hand and the feet can look like clubbing or club foot. And the other one, the intrauterine, when there is anything wrong in the uterus, then there could be more deformities, more weaknesses. Joints develop in the 5th to 6th week of pregnancy, and the joint needs enough space to move around so that it is flexible. But when it doesn't get that space, there is a decreased range of motion or it becomes fixed. This happens because of the accumulation of connective tissue which is there and which makes the joint fixed. So the reasons of joint becoming fixed is that there is not enough space for the fetus to move around, like in cases when there is multiple pregnancy, which is like fetal crowding, or there is any other tissue growing around the uterus, or when the mother is having any viral infection, or she's taking any drugs, or she had any trauma on her abdomen, that could also lead to this condition, or any low level of amniotic fluid which is not letting the fetus to move around as comfortably as normal. Next cause is genetic cause. Only single copy of abnormal gene is enough for the appearance of the disease, and the abnormal gene can be inherited from either of the parent or it can be a result of a gene mutation, and the risk of passing of the abnormal gene is equal for both the offspring. But if that gene is recessive X linked, then the males have a higher risk of getting that disease. Next is CNS and PNS, disorders that are associated with arthrogryposis
multiplex congenita may consist of conditions like meningomyocele when the brain and the spinal cord do not close, or muscular atrophies when there is muscular muscle weakness, or disorders where there is incomplete development of certain portions of the brain. All these lead to non-development of these particular structures, and these are again related to genetics, so it is not a separate cause.
Arthrogryposis in its most severe form is detected just after birth, but when the patient is presenting late, then the first thing is having a diagnosis. First is including of observation, where the symptoms are asked, a detailed history is taken, whether about any viral infection to the mother or any drug use or any twin birth or anything related to that, or any history of decreased amniotic fluid. And all after this, then a clinical evaluation is then followed by a nerve conduction velocity, then EMG where the muscle strength is taken, or muscle biopsy is done. Imaging studies can also be done, taking MRIs, and then a comparative genomic hybridization is done, which means that DNA testing is done to check for those genes. Treatment is individual based. Every patient of arthrogryposis has different clinical presentations, like somebody has problem in the limb, some upper limb, or somebody in the lower limb. So all these things are different. So based on that, the treatment is planned, and a multidisciplinary approach is taken for the best outcome of the patient. And the goal should be realistic, and it should be assessed every now and then, and it should be changed accordingly after every surgeries. And the primary pediatric surgeon should form a team with the most experienced and exceptional team of health professionals to give the maximum benefit to his patient. Most of the patients with arthrogryposis present mild stiffness only. So it can be managed by physical therapy alone, and with gentle mobilization and stretching is enough. And removable splint or dynamic splints are given, which permit movement, and it keeps the joint in certain angle for and gives stretching to the joint. And serial casting, like for every 1 week, casting is given and it's removed. It's just the same treatment as I discussed in the CTEV. Please go and check that out if you haven't. Psychosocial and emotional therapy. Any physical disability, even for adults, is very disheartening and emotional. Everybody tends to have decreased self-confidence in such condition. So these children who are undergoing multiple surgeries in case of severe AMC, they need to be nicely counseled, and even their family needs to be counseled that these things are small issues, they are petty issues, they have greater virtues in life, and they can excel, they have other qualities. They need to be counseled, they need to be psychologically stable and happy, because more than this condition, this thought that they have some social stigma makes them more unhappy. In severe cases, surgical treatment is required to improve the ROM of ankle, knee, hip, elbow, etc. But since this affects only the joint, in rare cases only tendon transplant is done. And since the primary is a pediatric surgeon, other approaches from a pediatrician, a neurologist, a plastic surgeon, an orthopedist, a rehabilitation physician, a therapist, and a medical geneticist is required. And having the best of them who have worked together is for the best interest of the patient. And other treatment like having psycho and social therapy is again required, even without surgery or with surgery. Surgical approaches, frames and devices like Taylor spatial frame, Elizarov's frame, all these are stainless steel discs and rods which are fixed to the bone, and they are held with pins and struts, and the tension in the wire are adjusted to distribute the force through the top and bottom disc. And you can see in this picture the external fixator. This is easy to maintain, and elongation from outside, and as the bone grows, this is helpful, and it has less chance of infection and is a better option. Growth modulation. By this procedure, minimally invasion is done, and the growth plate from where the bones of the children grow is temporarily altered, which leads to the bone growing in a straightened manner, and it's like a medical breakthrough for these type of conditions. Prognosis and conclusion. AMC is not a progressive disorder. This is very important to remember, that whatever changes happened during the intrauterine life, and now that condition is fixed. Once it is cured, once the surgery is done, it will not progress to anything further bad. There is no degeneration or something happening. So a patient can live a very productive, rewarding and independent life with the help of physiotherapy and surgical intervention if required. Now, talking about success stories of patient with AMC. In this picture, we can see Nicholas Taylor. He's an American 3-time Paralympic champion of quads tennis. Can you say which one of them is he? Just look into the picture, look into the their limbs and guess. This is the question, this is the quiz I was talking about. Yes, you have time. Think about it, see more conditions, and then I will ask you again. This is Lee Pearson, a British 11 times gold medal winner at the Paralympic Games in dressage. You can see he is having the club hand, and yes, he has AMC. This is Mike Begum, a fighting competitive game player. He's been the best for many years. Sunny Taylor, an American painter and activist. I'm a fan of her work. Really, I thought there's a man standing behind. And yes, she also has AMC. This is Luca Pitoli, also known as Lazy Legs. He's a Canadian boy dancer and he is all over the internet. He is an amazing dancer. Marty Sheedy, he's an activist and a motivational speaker. This is him in the next picture. Prudence Mabena, she's a lead singer for the band Liana. So, have you made your guesses? No? Let me help you out. The first and the third guy, they seem to have perfect upper and lower limb. But the second and the fourth guy, they seem to have contractures in the lower limb. And when you see into the upper limb, you see the clubbing appearing in the guy who's at the extreme right. Right? Right? Yes, right. I hope by now you have learned how to make a observational diagnosis of arthrogryposis multiplex congenita without having your tongues twisted. Thank you. And the only disability in life is a bad attitude, as rightly said by Scott Hamilton. Thank you for staying till the end. When life gives you arthrogryposis, say arthrogryhosis. Make it as easy and give more importance to things which are important, like virtues, like good nature and being happy. Thank you. If you like this video, do subscribe and press the bell icon so that whenever I post a new video, you get the update and it's absolutely free. And this will encourage me to make more of such medical videos. Take care, stay healthy, stay safe, and wear your mask and wash your hands. Thank you.